From Wall Street to Main Street, News 8's Project Economy is our commitment to coverage beyond the headlines. I'll don't tell a woman from Portland there's no future in Maine's wood products industry. In fact, Louise Johnitis has bet the bank on a bright future, purchasing four closed-down mills in just the past year. News 8's Steve Minnick joins us now from the newsroom with a closer look at what some would say is a risky investment. Steve.
Well, Tracy, Louise Johnitis herself is the first to admit, yes, she is taking a very big risk, but she also believes the timing is right. Either way, though, for now, she has given new life to some wood mills many had left for dead. Inside the Saunders Brothers Mill in Greenwood, that deafening buzz of big machinery means business is back.
It's our heartbeat. Keeps the store busy, keeps us busy. It was just sad to see the parking lot empty out.
Barely 6 months after more than 40 workers lost their jobs when the mill shut down, nearly a dozen are back, turning out brush handles, dowels, and custom rolling pins.
So this is part social experiment, part really good deal that happens to line up with the fact that we need jobs in Maine.
Louise Johnitis grew up in Rumford. Her father worked at the local paper mill. Last summer, she purchased this mill at auction for $450,000, roughly one-third of its assessed value. With little debt and an abundance of what she calls supply, Johnitis believes this mill can make money.
You need a supply of raw material, which we have here in Maine, which is wood. You need talent, which we have because people in Maine have worked in the wood industry for hundreds of years.
I foresee no reason why she can't make it happen at this point in time.
We're just cut to a certain size.
With more than two decades at this mill, Dewey Bunker has witnessed the industry's decline firsthand, blaming in good part the flood of cheap imports. But he believes, as does Johnitis, the world market is changing, that the price of wood products from other countries will soon rise significantly.
I still believe that at some point in time, their labor costs are going to get to a point where it's easy for these U.S. manufacturers to come back, and I believe it's not that far off.
Their citizens will want to be paid more and will want to have a better lifestyle. So really, I'm kind of reinventing what we already used to do, just reinventing it at the right time.
Not many here in Greenwood believe they'd ever see anyone working this mill again. But within a year, Johnitis hopes to triple her workforce. And while admittedly it's a risky venture, she's convinced with a quality product, this Maine mill can thrive.
Probably what I had the most of, I think, is a vision. I had a vision that something will have to happen in Maine and I want to be a part of it.
Along with the mill in Greenwood, Johnitis has also bought a sawmill in Freiburg and two furniture mills in Andover and Monson. By next spring, she plans to be manufacturing furniture in that Monson plant, hiring an additional 30 or so employees. In the newsroom, Steve Minnick, News 8.